Greetings, friends. Alex King Harris here, also known as Rara Avis. I just wanted to take some time and share something I'm really passionate about. It's a book called The Presence Process by Michael Brown. And here is a copy. Here's my copy. Presence Process. The Presence Process was something I actually first did with my partner, Naomi, together. We did it as a way for me to start shifting out of some mental health issues, addiction issues. I certainly, for most of my adult life, have struggled with substance abuse, anxiety, depression, and just generally, like, you know, hardcore negative thinking. And the Presence Process was really something that helped lift me up out of that and gave me some tools, some really great tools to help me deal with my mind and, you know, my ways of coping with stress. And so there's a lot to the book, and I would say, you know, to just get it, if you're feeling like you need something simple and yet powerful in your life that can be with you for the rest of your life, it's a really good reason to start getting into Michael Brown's work. So just a little bit of background. Michael Brown was originally a music journalist, and in his own words, living a fairly unawake life. And he contracted a neurological disorder that caused severe pain spasms to come over his whole body multiple times a day. And as I understand it from reading, you know, reading his words around it, the prognosis was generally it's uncurable, and that most people who suffer from it either became addicted to hard drugs or committed suicide due to the frequency and intensity of the pain. And so that set him off on a healing journey where he explored many, many, many different ways of trying to address this problem. And ultimately, his path led him to breathwork. And it was a specific type of breath work that I feel like is a little bit different than sort of the general sphere of holotropic breathing or long-form uninterrupted breathing. And to boil it down, it basically means for 15 minutes in the morning and 15 minutes at night, you breathe consciously, connectedly, so you're just regular breathing in and out. Like this. For 15 minutes nonstop, and with each breath you have a word, and the words join together into a complete sentence, a mantra. And so on the inhale it's I, exhale is am, inhale here, exhale now, inhale in, exhale this. So I am here now in this. And you just repeat that to yourself over and over again. And the beautiful thing about mantra is it gives the brain something to do. So you're fully allowing the brain to get focused and be of use. And you're doing it in tune to your breath, which is a very inwardly aligning process, right? And so that's the sort of basic part of the presence process that you can do anytime. And in fact, after I'm done talking about it, we're going to do 5 minutes of just presence process breathing. Now, in the book, like I said, he recommends 15 minutes morning and night. But the beautiful thing is the way he sets you up for success is by helping to address all of the ways in which you can distract yourself or not be fully responsible for your own quality of your experience day to day in life. And he really helps you kind of look down inside of yourself to the places where your ways of coping with stress and your ways of protecting yourself from traumatic experiences that have happened to you in your life, that there are ways to sort of start to slowly pull apart that manageably. Okay, so you can start to manage the inner landscape of your being and deal with some of these discomforts, emotional discomforts, by what arises when you do your breath work, and also by the insights that the book helps you focus on. So once you start the process, each week you're going to be given a presence activating statement. And the statement itself is like a self-therapeutic tool. And it's something you keep with you while you're doing the presence process, but also while you're just with yourself during your day-to-day life. And the presencing tool really helps disarm the part of you that is trying to protect itself. It helps you get down into the uncomfortable places. It helps you to stay present while you're feeling uncomfortable feelings. And it really helps elevate your consciousness to a place where you can be solely responsible for your own self-care, and you can really hold yourself and learn how to regulate yourself back into presence. So by presence, meaning not distracted by thoughts of the past or projecting thoughts into the future. And, you know, there's so much out there to support that staying present is good for the nervous system, good for your mood, good for your state of being. It takes a lot of energy to be stuck in the past and future. I should know. I do it all the time. It's like one of my things, as with many people. You know, and I've got a laundry list of faults and issues and ways of thinking that don't work for me. And I just know that if I can gift myself the presence process, is actually the second time I've done it all the way through. And I don't do it perfectly. I screw it up sometimes. I'm not, you know, always on point, but I'm generally committed to doing the process. And I'm compassionate to myself when I have a bit of a fumble with it. But, you know, the overall results are amazing. So I just want to encourage you to do that. So let's just enjoy 5 minutes of uninterrupted breath. And as I said, the mantra is I am, I'm just setting my timer as I do this, here, now, in this. Okay. I am here, now, in this. With each inhale and exhale. So you inhale and you say a word silently to yourself, and you exhale and you say a word. Okay. I am here, now, in this. So let's pop off a 5 minute timer, and you can just breathe with me, or you can breathe at your own pace. If you're noticing that you're getting a little bit tired and a little bit, you know, faded feeling, you can increase the pace of your breath. And if you feel really overly alert and maybe even a little bit lightheaded, you can slow your breath down. So just finding that comfort spot for you. Okay. All right, here we go. And start my timer. We'll see you in 5 minutes. Thank you. enjoying some nice, silent, spacious time afterwards. So, you can sit for as long as you want after doing the presence process. You can do the presence process for longer, as I said in the book, 15 minutes. You can go for longer than that if you like. Just staying with that nice connected breathing, no pause between the inhale and the exhale. You can push the breath a little further, again, just expanding the breath all the way in, all the way out. But generally trying to focus on the mantra and just staying in a still space, observing yourself breathing. And then noticing what arises. Again, the presence process, Michael Brown. Grab yourself a copy of the book. It's excellent. This is the early first edition. There's a new edition that has slightly different altered presencing tools, but they're both great. I've read them both. And I hope this serves you. I hope that you get a chance to do a presencing reset anytime you need it during the day. It's a great way to deal with insomnia if you want to set yourself up for success at night. If you wake up at night and you can get up out of bed and just do 5, 10, 15 minutes worth of breath work, it really helps reset your nervous system, brings you back down to a more regulated state. So I wish you well. I wish you healthiness and happiness and joy. I hope your heart is tuning into what you need for yourself. And I hope you're finding ways to be generous and give to those that you care about. All right, all the best. Blessings. Until next time.